welcome to another one shot. Once again, I ran across this in the Nintendo Switch eShop. So, I played a little bit of this already, but I want to show it off because it reminds me of the Touhou series, which is just bullet hell shooter with anime-esque character. So, definitely not a whole lot of characters, and a little bit more of a horror-esque aspect to it, because monsters are not very, or the enemies aren't like characters. Okay, so one thing I already hate is this little tutorial section where they're telling you how to attack and stuff, because it's showing you a four-prong thing, but how is that helpful when you have two sets of, like, D-pad length? You have the A, B, A, and B, which, okay, yeah. Oh my god, this is so much easier playing on handheld. I kind of did not realize it would be. Switch has just been an awe-inspiring way of money suck of me just finding random things. Like this. And one of the last one-shots I did, Flood of Light, so. Oh man, I have to concentrate so I'm not getting hit. Oh good lord, why am I using the analog stick for movement? I just realized that. That's horrible. I wonder if I'm freaking out because I'm moving way too fast for what I want to be. Because I'm flicking the stick. That one. That one's larger. I'm gonna get rid of that one. Honestly, this seems slightly easier than the Touhou games. I think I put this on normal. But even in general, it seems slightly easier because I know I played through like two levels or a couple levels and I remember, I'm pretty sure the lives reset. Now that I can focus attack, this one's a lot easier. But, shit, I actually ran into it, didn't I? Like her, I fought before. And this is going so much faster! Did I accidentally get hit by something and not realize it? Probably. Yeah, it was probably that thing. Yeah, that was definitely what hit me, or I ran into it. Here's where it gets to be a little bit less of a Touhou-esque game. Because that's not something you'd ever see in Touhou. These two much harder, but still fairly easy for now. I imagine it gets even extremely tougher. Oh crap, I'm so close to missing that one too. Thank you. Fuck me. Concentrating. Eating. Continue. I'm doing too hard and trying to focus on everything that's happening. And I keep defaulting to the analog stick for no good reason. It's not a good button. At least not for this. Maybe because I've been playing it with other games. Like Dead Cells, another one of my win purchases. Let me do that. Oh, there we go. And the only thing I hate about it screaming up is that gets very pixelated. And I wish it didn't, like, they had refined the art itself a little bit more so it didn't go war, soul attack, or life. I'll pick life because I accidentally died and I never even used soul attack. Yeah, soul attack is the special meter. I'll do one more level because I know it gets harder, or at least. Hopefully I can avoid using the analogs. I like her spray. Both the characters do play differently. This character has a spread. The girl, that's all her name says, or suggests, is a homing attack kind of weapon. Which reminds me of Reimu from Touhou. And if I'm comparing this to Touhou a lot, it's because that's my main area of expertise when it comes to bullet hell. Like, that's my experience, for the most part, for bullet hell games. I've played a couple other ones, but Touhou was the most impactful one, I'd say. Or the one I took the most interest in, and the one I've actually played more of than any other one. Okay. So. Ooh. Skimming on the edge of death here. Shit. That's my last one that hit me. Almost hit me, rather. I forgot about the upcoming stuff. Fucking analog stick. Gotta get out of that habit. But then into the habit when I go and play Dead Cells again. It's horrible. That's almost gonna be easier if I play it with that one anyway. I'm just used to analog stick with it, so I prefer it. Also used analog stick since I've also been playing Monster Hunter Generations. So much good stuff is coming to Switch right now. Or in games in general that it's just hard to keep up sometimes. Okay, that's much faster when I can do this focus attack, because I was not using that the first time I was playing this. Get around. Okay, this next boss. I may have to do a maturity filter on this one. Because I just remembered. Yeah, that design is not for children in mind, at least from what I can view as it, because that seems way more mature. Oi, 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 oi. Wanna go slow, but the blue balls there are kind of terrifying. Yeah, that went a lot faster. And yeah, I I definitely feel like a mature filter or mature warning is fitting for this game. Holy shit. Holy shit. Maybe even a body horror warning. Because that's not something that's nice to see. Entirely. With someone contorting their back like that. Oh my god. Yeah. This is so much easier to pay attention to on handheld. And I recommend playing it in that way. And definitely not on your TV screen. Which is nice, because I literally bought the Switch of like, okay, here's all the games I can now play on console that I'm sick of playing on handheld. Like Monster Hunter Generations, I fucking hate on 3DS. So annoying, and I hate it. Damn it, I didn't even that thing yet. Not doing very well in terms of lives, but at the same time, and this is why I keep taking lives with soul attacks. Okay. Gonna keep going. I don't think I've gone past this point, at least on this mode. Good lord, I am fucking up early on. So who knows if I'll even make it to the boss. But again, my recommendation is stay strong at play this on handheld mode. Mode for the Switch. But I definitely do like that there are some games that I actually prefer to play on handheld. Oh. Because otherwise, it strictly just be a console thing for me. Like Dead Souls is in the realm of, I can play this on handheld. I also like playing it on like my TV and everything, but it's also something that is fine playing on handheld as well. For Monster Hunter Generations, I strictly only want to play on console in the docking station. Like I said, I hate Monster Hunter on the handhelds. They're horrible in my opinion. I mean, not horrible, but just having the tiny ass screen is so bad. Good lord, it's going horrible. So, I'm actually going to cut it here just because I'm fucking up super hard. And talking while I'm doing this is way out of my realm of ability. So, but I want to show it off a little bit, and if anyone is interested in Touhou-like games and probably better at them than I am, check this one out. I believe it's 13 something on the Switch, so definitely a lot of modes, a lot of different options for it. The characters are fairly minimal and there are only two, but at the same time, you sort of get two different playstyles of, let me actually show off one. Let me show off a little bit of. And you have local co-op, so if you have a friend who you both enjoy, you can play some of that. So, I'm gonna go back into normal, and instead of the Grim Reaper, I'll choose the girl. And I'm probably not even gonna go through the first boss with this, but you'll see very quickly that her type of shot is super different. I haven't seen her secondary shot at all, because I'm mainly playing with the Grim Reaper character. But yeah, see, she has a straight up attack, and it does homing. So if I don't move she'll still have shots to go off to the side. Our secondary... Okay, so our secondary remains... is sort of like the other ones, where the other girl will have it spread and then go into a straight shot, where hers, it's sort of a straight shot, but then we'll have homing beams that will go off the side. Her secondary, very slow movement is just a straight shot, no homing. So, that's fairly bare bones, simple, but you can see sort of the differences between the two. So those are the two characters that you can play as, and this has been, hopefully I'm saying this right, Shikhondo, which I'm probably saying it completely wrong, but that's the best I can do. You'll see in the title. I'll throw up on the screen if possible. Possible, but you like Touhou, you like Bullet Hell. I think this is a strong contender. And I like the art style. That's another, I always get grabbed in by art styles. Also, this is definitely one that I enjoy. I definitely like its menu art and everything. It seems potentially to have a small, untold story aspect to it. Of why this girl and this Grim Reaper are the ones doing this, but and I'd love to see if there's any more supplementary material after I get through it, but I enjoy it and definitely going to be playing in handheld from now on. But that's one of the fun parts of having just random digital games on the Switch. You pick them up whenever and take it with you.